Fargo of the Hyatt. Queens of Dublin Society, carelessly. I was just chatting this afternoon at the Viceregal Lodge to my old pal, Sir Robert and Lady Ball, Astronomer Royal, at the levee. Sir Bob, I said, 44R, Mrs. Yelbert and Mary. Roy retorts his local ball dress and elbow-length ivory gloves, wearing a sable-trimmed brick-silver dolman, a comb of brilliance and panache of osprey in her hair. Arrest him, constable. He wrote me an anonymous letter in Prentice backhand when my husband was in the North Riding of Tipperary on the Munster Circuit, signed James Lufford. He said that he had seen from the gods my perilous clothes as I sat in a box at the Theatre Royal at a command performance of Le Cigale. I deeply inflamed him, he said. He made improper overtures to me to misconduct myself at 4:30 pages M, on the following Thursday, Dunsink time. He offered to send me through the postal work of fiction by Monsieur Paul de Kock, entitled The Girl That the Three Cares of Stage. Mrs. Bellingham, Captain Seal Tony Mantle, wrapped up to the nose, steps out of her room and scans through tortoiseshell quick carrot sad face in glasses which she takes from inside her hippopotamus mug. Also to me, yes, I believe it is the same objectionable person. Because he closed my carriage door outside Sir Thornley's chauffeur as one sleety day during the cold snap of February 93 when even the grid of the Wasp type and Ball Stout and my bath cistern were frozen. Subsequently he enclosed a beam of Edelweiss held on the height, as he said, in my honor. I had it examined by a botanical expert and elicited the information that it was a blossom of TLIE homegrown potato plant growing from a fortune case of a model farm. Mrs. Yelbert and Barry. Shame on him. A CTFFIUV is slept in ragamuffin search of drawers. The slept in ragamuffin. Screaming. Stop piece one. Hurrah there, Bluebeard. Three cheers for IP Mo. Second watch. Produces handcuffs. Here are the Darby. Mrs. Bellingham. He addressed me in several handwritings with fulsome compliments of the 442 Venus infers an alleged profound pity for my frostbound coachman Palmer while in the same breath he expressed himself as envious of his ear flaps and FCC sheepskins and of his fortunate proximity to my person, when standing behind my chair wearing my livery and the armorial bearings of the Bellingham escutcheon garnished sable, a buck-head keyboard. He lauded almost extravagantly my nether extremities, my swelling calves and silk hose drawn up to the limit and eulogized glowingly my other hidden treasures and priceless lace which, he said, he could conjure up. He urged me, stating that he felt it his mission in life to urge me, to defile the marriage bed, to commit adultery at the earliest possible opportunity. The Honorable Mrs. Mervyn Cowboy. On the sad face, on costume, hard hit, Jack Boots Scottsford, vermilion waistcoat, fawn muscular gauntlet by this braided drum, long train held up and hunting crop with which she strikes her well constantly. Care it also me. Because he saw me on the polo ground of the Phoenix Park at the match all Ireland versus the rest of Ireland. My eyes, I know, shone divinely as I watched Captain Slaughter Dennehy of the Inniskillings win the final chuckar on his darling top centaur. This Korean Don Juan observed me Mr. Bellingham shakes her muffin tea sad face, parroting glasses. Make him smart, Hannah.